G'day Two Stroke fans, welcome back. Yes, there's more. We've got a bit of a problem with YouTube. And the problem is that they want us to magically get 1,000 subscribers by February 20, or they demonetize everything and march us out of the herd. So that's not too good. And I am supposed to ask for subscribers all the time now, which would be really annoying because these are technical lectures, not entertainment videos, but aside. So, I had to come up with a solution. So this is the solution. We'll run the motor and then we can look at these values, the piston speed, etc., and the ports opening and all this sort of thing, and we can just see, oh, well, what have we got here? Yeah. Hey, I had to come up with something, you know, at short notice. That's, yeah, you know, desperate times, desperate measures. This time, we're going to get into a little bit more about our software model that we've talked about before, and we're going to do some numbers. So we're going to show you what the actual meaning of it is and how to actually put it into application with a real engine. And what we've got here is a viewer during episode 10 asked some questions about his kart engine, and he's given me this document here, which is a homologation document for a karting engine that he's got. It's a 100cc reed valve engine, IAME. It's all the specs there. And he asked me the questions about making modifications to it, and would I be able to give him some advice about, you know, what is being changed with those modifications. So what we're going to do is we're going to use our modeling software, which is a little bit more advanced than what it was before. And what we have here is some target information about our RPMs, exhaust temperatures, bore stroke, etc., etc., yada yada yada, timings. In this case, we've got a reed, so we've got no inlet, so we'll just knock that out. And then we've got some metrics here off the engine, and bore stroke ratio, swept volume, trap volume, etc., etc., etc. And then what we do here is we can actually move the engine in degrees, and each degree at that RPM, we can see what's going on in the engine. Okay, so as we move it over, our exhaust opens, our transfer opens, and this is again translated up here. As you can see on the site, there's our transfer port, our exhaust port. So if I was to, for example, change that to 150, that goes up, exhaust port goes up, we both go back down to 130, and we'll see our exhaust port go, a transfer port go down and change here. Okay, so now we can see at each degree at 12,000 RPM what's occurring. We can see what our piston speed is at a particular degree of angle. We can see how much the port's open and a number of other things, how far the piston is from the top. And there's our degrees in crankshaft degrees output. So what I'm going to do is put the information here that Dennis has given me, and we're going to see what effect a change on the base gasket is, because here's essentially the all of the modifications in the engine comes down to this base gasket changes. Our latitude of movement to raise and lower the bore is 0.2 millimeters, essentially. More than one gasket can be used. For the cylinder head, we're restricted to our combustion chamber volume, which is, that's including the piston dome. This one's a flat measurement across the top with the volume meter. Head gasket, we can, it says we can use a head gasket or not use a head gasket, which is different. The other ones specify that we have to have a gasket. And in these regulations, what the regulations don't specifically tell you you can do, you can't do. Okay, so you can't come up with something the regulations haven't covered. Head gasket, again, constrained by the squish gap of 1.05. So we're going to keep those things in mind. And the fact is we haven't got a separate squish. We've got a one-piece cylinder head. It's got markings on the inside there, so we can't do any machining there. We could probably give it a haircut to lower it at best. So what Dennis is asking me is what will the effect be? So I've put in the specs of the engine over here, which is up the top here. There we go. So 48.2 bore. 54.05 stroke max, theoretical bore 48.53. That just means when we match that with that, we get 100cc. whereas you can see at 5405, 48.2, we get a swept volume of 98 cc total. Now, after the ports are closed, okay, in other words, the volume at when that's just closed there is the trapped compression volume, or the trapped volume is 60 cc's. Mean piston speed, exhaust duration. Okay, I should have put the decimal there. I'll fix that. Now that's the sonic exhaust wave velocity. So I put in a temperature of 600 degrees, and he was talking an RPM target of 17,000, as far as I know. Okay, I checked the post, it's not there, so maybe that got edited out. If you could update me on that. I haven't put the combustion chamber volume in here to calculate the CR. I'll do that in due course. Okay, calculating that, 600 temperature, those exhaust port timings, all right. The values here given to us in the port map there only express timing as angular, okay? So it has to be read with a degree wheel with a gauge, 0.2 millimeter gauge, okay? So these measurements here, at this exhaust degrees and measurements, our distance from the top, we'll calculate that should be that. For the transfer, it should be that. So we would compensate for the 0.2 if we were going to do a measurement from the top of the bore down to the port to calculate our timing. Otherwise, we'll have to put a degree wheel on it and put a gauge in there and check our timing. Same deal. If we know the conrod length, we know the stroke, that's what we need to know to calculate those values. So now we know where our port heights are. Our widths here are expressed, chordal widths. We're going on our initial opening of transfer and initial opening of exhaust ports, not our extra ports. So 17,000, as I said, I've given a temperature of about 600 degrees Celsius in the exhaust. It may be lower, but that's not what I'm going to get to. Our tune length for this is 502.1 millimeters, okay? So 502.1 millimeters is our tune length. If we make a change to the base gasket, for example, if we, well, they're our maximum values. So we're going to have to drop the barrel. So let's just say we've got a 0.45 millimeter gasket under it, which is our maximum base gasket. We want to put the 0.25 and we'd want to drop it down 0.2 millimeters. So if we drop it down 0.2 millimeters, we're going to make these 0.2 longer. 1 to 3, and this one 4 to 6. And that'll give us new timings. All right, I'll press the button and do that in a minute. But what I want to show you is it's 502.1 millimeters is the tuned length at 17,000. Now, here's our new timings, okay? 168.62 degrees on the exhaust, 128.94 on the transfer. That's a maximum, so that can be 168.62, 128.9, 130 plus or minus 2, so that can be 128. So that's still within the legal, okay? Again, our tune length, the distance of the baffle cone from the exhaust port is 502.1 millimeters. If we update the new timings, what will that be? 499.2 millimeters. All right, we've got to change a couple of millimeters shorter. So now we change the RPM to find out and bring it back to our measurement. And we notice we've got a difference of 16,900, okay? So what does this all mean? It means that if we add on 0.2, so we drop the barrel, okay, to make the height effectively higher here, between here and here, effectively reduce the timing of both, to change it to slightly lower timing, the baffle cone length of a pipe is not adjustable in this engine, so it has to be the same distance. So in effect, we're bringing the peak power of the pipe down by only 100 RPM in doing that. So that's the change you're going to get in the sweet spot of RPM of the pipe, Dennis. And As to the pipe, it specifies the gaskets, everything. And here it says the exhaust gasket, only one gasket is permitted. Now, because it doesn't say you, it doesn't say if you use a gasket, you have to have a gasket and you can't have more than one. So there's nothing we can do about that. As you can see, the difference here between the two, the difference here between the two, 5.02 to 4.992. Yeah, what have we got there? About 3 millimeters difference in the pipe, okay? In the pipe tune length. So we can't do anything about it by changing the gaskets. So we're gonna have a difference of 100 RPM on the sweet spot. So it's gonna be 100 RPM lower with the barrel dropped, raise at 0.2, brings it up 100 RPM in the range, okay? And effectively these values also change as well. Now you'll see this part of it is the degrees. I'm getting there, so at piston, what we can do here is we can go from there, we can open our exhaust, and we can go down to our transfer blowdown stage, okay, about 8.3 millimeters of blowdown distance. Now the reason we calculate blowdown distance in piston distance and not angular degrees is because it changes. If I say dropped 20 degrees, okay, off these, just for example, okay, and I update that, and then I go back to the exhaust here, and I just open up to the transfer, blowdown stage is about 7.42. Blowdown's measured in millimeters of blowdown. So those are the differences you'll get with 100 RPM there. And the other thing I was going to do is your exhaust pipe expansion chamber, and just show you a couple of calculations here. So we take our expansion chamber, which is a little bit difficult to calculate the tuned length of the expansion chamber. That's 502, because it has to be to the piston window. Now you'll see this expansion chamber type is slightly different. We have a baffle cone, but the baffle cone is perforated, which means this has a fairly low back pressure, and this pipe is oriented to an engine with fairly low timings to try to get the engine to rev, so we don't get we don't get as much port plugging from this pipe. And that's what happens when we've got low timings, when we want to overcome it to get the engine to still rev up, because remember, this engine's revving to 17,000. Our expansion chamber doesn't tell us what angles these are, so just for your information, so you want to know what these angles are, we can calculate those. So we'll hit pipe calculator. Let's see, dimension A is 100 base millimeters, outlet 45 for our header pipe, and the lengths of the side, no, we've got center length on this one, E. So it's 193, okay, so we're gonna, that's our total angle. So our half angle of convergence divergence is 8.1 degrees. So your diffuser cone on this one is an 8-degree diffuser, which is about mid-range. You can go slightly shallower, or you can go a fair bit steeper. So it's a reasonably mild diffuser cone. And let's see what our baffle cone is. Now, baffle cone doesn't give us a centerline measurement, but it does give us a side measurement. So being that's a cut-off cone, I'm going to go from the longest side measurement. So we'll go again from our 100. Our outlet on here is dimension I at 23.5. So we go 23.5. And side length on this one. So this is for side length. So our side length is H at 180. And we'll calculate that at 24 degree total, 12.2 degree angle on the baffle. So you've got a around an 8 degree on your diffuser and around a 12 and a bit degree on your baffle cone on that particular chamber, just for your information. And so that's how you can tell from the previous videos the nominal figures that I gave you for angles of convergence divergence of the angles of the diffuser cone and the baffle cone. You can look in with those. All right. So I'll be doing a little bit more work on this, but if anyone's got any information like this that they want me to plug in and give them, spit out the readings, then yeah, no problem, I can do that. Just let me know in the comments section. Back to Dennis. Dennis, they're the outputs of raising or lowering the barrels, and as you can see, if you raise and lower the barrels, changing the cylinder head is going to have to be affected anyway to keep your combustion chamber volume within the values and to maintain your squish, okay? So it's a little bit difficult to change the cylinder head gasket without changing the others, and if you change the base gasket, you're going to have to change the cylinder head gasket. So essentially, your mode of adjustment is essentially the base gasket, is what it comes down to. You may want to try a wider combustion chamber value, but I don't think that's going to work out to the benefit. And yeah, if you've got any more questions, just let me know. And if anyone else has, hit the comment section. Be more than happy to answer them. And yeah, you know, can we do a miracle February the 20th and get 1,000 subscribers? We've got 673 now, so miracles do happen sometimes. I'm eternally hopeful, and we'll see what happens. And I will see you in the next video, which will be coming sooner than the last gap that I've had for a couple of weeks. Probably next week. I might do another one this weekend, see how we go. And that will do it for now. Okay, bye folks.